Hi, this is Eileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the manual fixing tools in Magix. In Magix, you can do fixing in three different ways. You can apply automatic fixing, you can use the Fix Wizard for semi-automatic fixing tools, or you can use the manual fixing tools. The manual fixing tools are only needed in exceptional cases to assist the automatic or semi-automatic tools at a specific fixing step. If you'd like to learn more about the automatic and semi-automatic fixing options, please see our tutorials on these topics. In order to demonstrate the different capabilities of the manual fixing tools, I'll be using a part that has been distorted on purpose and apply manual fixing on it. You can find most of the manual fixing tools in your default Fix Ribbon or in the manual options in the Fix Wizard. We can see from the diagnostics page that our part has a lot of errors. Let's start with the first page, Normals. Although it's not common, you can use this option when there's a region of inverted normals in a part that are misleading the automatic or semi-automatic fixing tools, for example. Under the manual options, you can invert individual triangles, a marked region, a shell, or a complete part. Then, we'll follow with stitching the connections between the triangle edges. For example, in case you would like to enforce a certain stitching tolerance, you can use this option. Magix will always estimate a stitching tolerance for a part, which you can change, and even decide on the number of stitching iterations. Next, noise shells. Magix can give you a complete list of shells, including the noise shells. You can use this option to inspect the artifacts that are creating the noise shells. You can hide the shell that is your part, and manually inspect the shells that you suspect are noise. If you click on Detect Noise, Magix can detect all noise shells automatically, and you can delete them by clicking on Delete Selected Shells. Holes occur if there are triangles missing from a shell. If your part has holes with complex geometries, you can use this option. I'll use a different part for this example to demonstrate the different hole fixing algorithms available. Planar hole filling is ideal for relatively flat surfaces. The ruled hole filler is useful when you have a curved surface. You can create a bridge to act as a reference, indicate it as a reference, and then fill the hole. For irregular holes, you can use the freeform hole filling tool. Choose the level of sensitivity and fill the hole. Under triangles, intersecting triangles can be detected and fixed with the tools under manual options. In case there are intersecting triangles on your part, which are out of your tolerances for automatic or semi-automatic fixing, you can use this option. Detect intersecting will detect and mark the intersecting triangles. Depending on the geometry, you can fix intersections by unifying or trimming intersecting triangles. Overlaps can be similarly detected and corrected by the functions on the Overlaps page. In case there are overlapping triangles in your part, which are out of your tolerances for automatic or semi-automatic fixing, you can use this option. Depending on the geometry, you can choose to delete these triangles and fill the hole. You can remove sharp triangles, or you can use the Move Part Points option to drag down the corner of the overlapping triangle. The last but not the least, if there are multiple shells in a part, they can be detected and, for example, unified manually. In order to ensure that the shells of your parts weren't disconnected during the conversion from CAD to STL, for example, you can use this option. Finally, we can see from the diagnostics page that our part is fully fixed and ready to print. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.